Walk on the path, both of you in heart. It's a highway One more. We're having a little technical difficulty here, which is crazy, but we praise God this morning.
Yes.
We bring greetings to you this morning.
Yes.
From the Sanctuary of Living Waters Ministries in
yes.
Claymont, Delaware,
yes.
where
yes.
Pastor Gene yes. Braddon is the pastor.
Yes.
Amen. And we just bless God for what he's doing here today. Amen. And
yes.
For those who don't know me, I am Pastor Sam Gale. I am associate pastor here with Pastor Brent. And we just say good morning in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
We just want to take some time and give God the blessings today. We just want to take the time to say thank you, Jesus.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
And we thank him for being just our all in all. This morning. So God, in the midst of all that's going on, we praise you, God.
Yes.
We bless you, God.
Yes.
We invite you in right now
yes.
to be with us right here where we are,
yes.
giving you the praise, the honor, and the glory, God,
yes.
in the name of Jesus. So Lord, with that, we're just going to say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And I ask the redeemed of the Lord, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And with a loud voice, shout amen.
Amen.
For God is good and his mercies endure forever. Amen. We're just suffering a little technical difficulty here, but we're going to do what God says anyway. Amen. Turn it down. Amen. So Sanctuary Baptist Fellowship Church, we welcome you in the name of Jesus Christ. We send greetings to the whole body. And we send a special greeting to my friend, my pastor, and my confidant, Pastor Anthony Lester. We pray right now and we ask God for blessings upon him, his family, and all that are associated with him, even the church family. We pray that everybody is okay and that everybody understands that trouble doesn't last always.
That's right.
And joy does come in the
yes.
morning. Amen. So we thank you for that. Today we're just going to take a few minutes. Amen. Praise
amen.
God. As the few minutes that God gives us to go ahead and to talk to you a little bit about what God has said for this moment and this day.
Mm-hmm.
So if you would, you get out your sword and let's turn to the book of John, the 15th chapter, St. John 15. And we're just going to spend a little time there. This is the same scripture that we are studying in Bible study. It's the same scripture that God has given us to spend some time in to work out something that's going on with us. Amen. Mm. So I just want to take the time and say, you know, God, in the midst of all that's going on in 2020, a year that has been deemed a year of challenges.
Yes.
A year where we find, first of all, we start off around the month of March, and we end up with a worldwide pandemic. And the people are trying to understand exactly what happened. This is one of those times where man does not have control.
Amen.
It's one of those times where man still can't find out. He says he's 90% sure he has something that will work, but we don't know. But I'm going to talk to you today about somebody who's 100% at all times, who brings us to a place so we're victorious.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Amen. And the word of God here says, I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. Mm-hmm. And every branch, he purges it, and it may bring forth more fruit. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purges it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you.
Thank you, Jesus.
As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine.
Yes.
No more can ye except ye abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit, for without me ye can do nothing. Amen. We praise God for that. We're going to keep going. If a man not in me, he is cast forth as a branch and is withered. And men gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. If ye abide in me, and my words in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you.
Yes.
Herein is my Father glorified, that ye bear much fruit, so shall ye be my disciples. As the Father hath loved me, so have I loved you. Continue in my love. If ye keep my commandments, ye shall abide in my love. I'm sorry, I lost my spot. ye shall abide in my love, even as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things have I spoken to you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Just want to talk here in particular about, in the book of John, we see this in the Gospel according to John, as he penned it, he's writing a lot of words that Jesus actually spoke. In many other Bibles, mostly the King James Version, you will find that these scriptures are in red. Red scriptures are usually quotes of exactly what Jesus said, and John has captured it here for us.
Yes.
So I want to take account that although the word is inspired, this here is the actual account that Jesus had. Now here, this talk that Jesus happened with them is either in the upper room, right before Judas betrays him, or we find that it's on the way to Gethsemane. He in the whole book of John, he is letting them know that even though soon I won't be with you, I will be with you.
Yes.
I'm going to leave you something here that's going to help you out and to know who I am and to know that I am with you.
Yes.
I want you to understand that I am the true vine and my Father is the husband. And I just want to take a time today to talk a little bit about being connected to the vine.
Jesus.
Connected
Hallelujah.
To the I am. Because
yes.
When you're connected to the I am, you're connected to the source.
Yes.
When we start looking at this, Jesus is given a parable here that he is a vine, or if you will, a tree. And that the tree gives nutrients to all of the branches.
Yes.
And all that comes out from it. So the vine is the tree, and the branches are those that extend from the tree. But you got to understand something about this. The roots are at the bottom of the tree.
Yes.
And what happens to us when we understand in horticulture, if you take a plant and you want to make it something different, or you want to make a hybrid, you take that plant, you cut it on an axis, and then you make a V notch in there. You take the plant that you want to engraft into it, you cut that on a V, and you put it to that, and then you tie it together with twine.
Yeah.
And before you know it, both of them are together, or they are entwined, they have become one.
Yeah.
And the thing about it is, in the midst of this, now that we are Christians, we have been engrafted, we have been tied together with Christ. And see, there's something about being connected to the I Am. In the I Am, we find that He is the one who supplies everything that we need. There is nothing done without Him. And He's telling us here that if you are part of me, that you have to bear fruit. Because if you don't bear fruit, guess what? It's going to be cut off and thrown in the fire. But then all those of us who are part of Him that bears fruit, He said, I want you to understand, every once in a while, I'm going to have to cut you back so that you can grow up to be something else. So therefore, Christians are hybrids, kind of. If you understand what a hybrid is, they always talk about hybrid cars. A hybrid car is one that usually can use a fossil fuel and also a different type of fuel. We find it most in cars that can use electric as well as gasoline. So when it's riding on the highway, it's using gasoline. But it's, when it's in town, it's using electric. It's going back and forth because it's recharging the batteries. So it's saving you on gasoline. That's why we have to understand that we are natural, but we're also spiritual. Because we've been engrafted into what's called spiritual Israel. Spiritual Israel is not based on how you were born. It's based on the connection to Christ. It's based on becoming one with the Creator and knowing that you are part of Him. Because I am in Him and He is in me, and the Father takes care of all of it. Amen. We have to understand that in this book of John, Jesus said throughout the whole book, I am in seven places. He begins to talk about that I am the good shepherd. He says that I am the one that I will lay down my life for my sheep. Understanding that a shepherd is one that has a hook and he has a long stick. On one end he uses to pull the sheep back into the fold. On the other end he's killing bears and lions. So therefore, he's saying, you know what? At one end, I got the rod of correction. The other end, I got the rod of protection. Ah, that's my God. That's who I serve. So this is the God that we're talking about. The one who comes and he says, you know what? I need to ring you in a little bit because you've veered off some. But I'm here to let you know that I'm God that will take care of you. I'm God that will protect you. I'm God that will meet all of your needs. He also wants you to know that God says that once you've been engrafted, you're peculiar. He describes His people 11 times in the Bible using the word peculiar. 9 times in the Old Testament and 2 times in the New Testament. We find it once in Titus. And then we find it again where we're so used to, the one in Ephesians, that says, you know what? You're a peculiar people. A chosen generation. Amen. He lets us know that you are not the same. That you know what? You are a house that was made not with hands. But you are a spiritual house. And you got to understand, in the tabernacle lies the Spirit of God. And then Jesus said, you know what? With that comes there's some benefits of being connected to the I Am. When you're connected to the I Am, He says, and He tells us in the Bible that, you know what? That there will be a time where you'll do greater things than I've done. And you will go out and you will heal in my name, according to my, under my power. You will speak according to my name and under my power. Things will happen. You got to understand, Christians, you are ordinary people with extraordinary powers. Because the power of all life is down on the inside. The I Am that Jesus is, it's not just the I Am and of then. He's the I Am of now and the I Am of forever. And the thing that happens with that I Am, He wants you to know I am right now, but I'm also eternal. So as my Father is from eternity to eternity, so am I. Because my Father and I are one.
Yes.
He sent me here to teach you with 33 years, my 33 years. And in my 3 years I was of ministry, I was here, I was able to help you understand the entirety in my word of what God said. He came to fill it. He was the Messiah. See, the people of Israel were looking for a valiant warrior to come and save them. Someone who would save them with horses and chariots. But God sent one that would save your soul for eternity.
Yes.
One that would bring you to a place of eternal peace, a place of eternal joy, a place of eternal happiness in Him. Because you got to understand, first of all, there is no other source in the world that's going to bring you to a place that you can have joy in the midst of the storm.
Right.
And in the midst of being one who's connected to the I Am, you got to understand that we are those people who have power to walk in places that we shouldn't be able to walk.
Jesus.
We are the ones who are able to go in when people said no, and you say, God said yes, that belongs to me.
Yes.
We are people who are able to say that I'm able to overcome, because not because of me, but because of the testimony of the saints and the blood of the Lamb.
Yes.
Connected to the I Am, you know what? There's deliverance.
Yes.
Connected to the I Am, there's healing.
Yes.
Connected to the I Am, the captives are set free. Connected to the I Am, you got to understand there's liberty. Being connected to the I Am brings you to a place that you know that God has set you free. Connected to the I Am. They always talk about one of those credit cards that says membership have its benefits.
Yeah.
But I'm here to tell you right now, connected to the I Am, there's some benefits that card can't do for you. Because when that card runs out and when you don't make your payments, you're all cut off. But Jesus said, I am the root. And he said here, and he tells us that if we ask something of God, he will give it to us if it's according to his will.
Yes.
That's why when we ask not amiss. We're not asked just because we say we want it. We ask because God, it's in your will. I believe it's in your will. And you'll reveal it to me in your word, what you would have me to say. That's why I'm so elated today to say, those of us who are connected, stay connected. Well, how do I stay connected? You stay connected in your prayer life.
Yes.
You stay connected in studying.
Yes.
You stay connected in a relationship, because we are in relationship with Jesus. We are in relationship with the root. We're in relationship with the vine.
Yes.
We are in relationship with the I Am.
Yes.
We are in relationship with God.
Yes.
We got to understand, in that relationship, I am connected. And in that relationship, you know what? I have to talk to you. I have to communicate with you so that I can let you know. And then, you know what? I have to be quiet sometimes so I can listen.
Yes.
That's what happens. But if you're not connected, you don't have that assurity.
Mm-hmm.
See, because connected with the I Am, you find that's where the gifts of the Spirit comes from.
Yes.
You know, that's where we see things, we hear things.
Yes.
That's where we can speak in unknown tongues. That's where we can
yes.
do all kinds of things in the name of Jesus that the world outside of God doesn't understand.
Mm-hmm.
And then being connected, we also have the joy of the fruit of the Spirit, joy and love and kindness and faith. You can't have the fruit of the Spirit without being connected to the vine.
Yes.
You have to be connected to the I Am in order for the fruit of Spirit to flourish in your life. And you got to understand something about the fruit of the Spirit. As you begin to bear fruit, God begins to prune you. You say, sometimes I'm doing everything that God told me to do, but yet I'm still going through. Look at it. It's a time when he's saying, you know what? I need your branch to grow a little bit longer. I need your branch to expand out. I need you to do more in my kingdom. I'm going to cut you a little bit so that you can grow out more. That's being connected to the I Am.
Yes.
And in the midst of that, when we're connected to the I Am and we're working out our soul salvation, we're being a part of the body of Christ, we come to a place that we understand that God is glorified.
Yes.
All this Jesus' ministry did, he always said that my Father would be glorified.
Yes.
After he raised Lazarus, he said, you know what? I did this so my Father would be glorified.
Yes.
If that's why he had to stay in the grave 3 days.
Yes.
I had to wait till he stinketh before I showed up so that you would know that no man did this. It was no witchcraft and no sorcery, but it was the power of God that raised Lazarus from the dead. Because I am connected to the I Am, I can speak a word and God can say it can come true. So in the midst of this, he says those who are not connected will be cut down. I don't care how much money you have, because your money won't be following you to your destination. Money won't work in eternity. Amen. It doesn't matter. And we always say here, a Brinks truck will not follow you on the day that the hearse is taking your body down the river. Amen. And all the gold that you have and all the millions and billions that you have won't help you. I'm here to tell you today that the President of the United States is not your source, is not your root, but it's the I Am. I'm here to tell you today that there's no government that's your source, but it's God that is the I Am. Yeah. Even in the midst of this COVID, they said this year is like a pinata of a 4-foot hornet's nest. When you hit it, everything came out and it just stung all over the place. But I'm here to tell you that even in the midst of that, the I Am can make it so that he has a salve for our sores, that we are healed by him.
Yeah.
There's power in the I Am.
Yeah.
And he says in verse 10, if you keep my commandments, you shall abide in my love, even if I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love.
Yes.
The thing about it, there comes a time when you have to understand that being a part of the I Am is not just saying I'm a part of the I Am. Mm-hmm. It's being a part of the I Am. It's about living a part of the I Am. It's about walking a part of the I Am. We got to understand that Jesus said also in John, I am the way, the truth, and the life. There's no other way but by me. You got to understand that when connected to the I Am, you have to always follow after the precepts and the commandments of Jesus to know that I'm connected to the I Am. And then he says, the things that I have spoken unto you, that your joy might remain in you and that your joy might be full. You got to understand in the midst of the I Am, there's joy.
Yes.
Joy is not based on your circumstance.
That's right.
It's not based on how you feel, because your feelings change every 10 minutes or so.
That's right.
It's not based on what you look like. Joy is based on knowing that I have the sovereign one down on the inside of me. And he's protected me. He's providing for me.
Yes.
He's healing me. He's delivering me.
Yes.
He's making it so that I have food to eat.
Yes.
He's the one that's looking beyond my faults and meeting my needs.
Yes.
This is the I Am that's the root of all my life, all my strength. He's my shield, my buckler. He's the one that takes care of me. He's the one that says when they come to devour me, I'll stand in the way. When the enemy comes in like a flood, I'll raise up a standard. And he also says that I will not see my seed begging bread. You got to know there's a difference between asking for bread and begging for bread. He did not say we would not ask. He said we would not be begging. Because he didn't tell us that anywhere in the world that true prosperity had anything to do with material. He does bless us with material things because he's our Father, and he would not hold any good thing from us. But he wants you to know that your prosperity is connected to the I Am. Your prosperity is connected to knowing who I Am. Your prosperity is connected to knowing that no matter what happens, I'm a child of God. You know what? When I sink to my lowest point, you know what? He's still with me. He said he'd never leave nor forsake me. Forsake is to abandon or condemn.
That's right.
He said he would never do that for us. So I'm here to tell you today that if you're not connected to the I Am, get connected to the I Am.
Yeah.
And those of us who aren't, who are, we need to just make sure we stay connected.
Yeah.
I understand that God has blessed us in the midst of all that's going on. Even with COVID.
Yeah.
As a living witness, a person who has contracted it, lived through it, mm-hmm. been fully restored, mm-hmm. I know there's a God.
Yes, 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 yes. Hallelujah.
And also, I understand that, you know what? He made it so that it wasn't something big for me. I thought I had a cold. But God blessed me in the midst of it. So, here we understand that all that we do, we need to glorify God.
Yes.
We need to make sure that in the midst of doing what we do, we need to stand in the gap for others.
Yes.
We need to pray for those who would willfully hurt us.
Yes.
Pray for our enemies.
Yes.
Don't let the election determine how you live.
That's right. Yes.
Let the I Am determine how you live. That I don't live in the election, I live in the root.
Yes.
I live in the I Am. I live in Jesus. So therefore, I will say this. You don't want to be one that's not being pruned.
Right.
If he's not ever pruning you, you might want to check that. Because there are some blessings that are in the pruning.
Yes.
Sometimes he has to cut away some things.
That's right.
Even things that we like, things that we think are beneficial, so that he comes to a place to say, you know what, I have something more for you.
Yes.
He might take you from a place of flourishing in something to a place of destitute in something, so that you might be a blessing in the kingdom.
That's right.
Some of us won't walk into our offices in a fivefold ministry until God takes us to Kneebone City.
That's right.
So we've been stripped down to everything we have. We have to understand, you know what? Jesus said, you know, these things have I spoken to you, that your joy would remain full. That everything that you have and everything that you think about, I want you to understand that it's not that dismal. He said, because I'll turn your mourning into dancing.
Yeah.
And then he says, you know what? I'll make sure that you understand that you need both the sunshine, but you need the Son of Man to live.
Yeah.
Because it says without the sunshine, that after a while, it won't take long before the whole earth would be cold. And then in a few hundred years, it would be minus 400 some degrees. Nothing would live on the earth.
Right.
So you need the sunshine that God's providing.
Yes.
But you need the shine of the sun that he has already given us on the inside of you. That it would radiate, that they would understand that you are the salt of the earth.
Yes.
You are the light. You are the living epistle that's walking.
Yeah.
Because you have the I am on the inside. The true vine that you've been engrafted into. That I've been engrafted into.
Yeah.
That we understand that in our lives, our purpose is to bring forth more fruit.
Yeah.
Our purpose is to glorify our God. Our purpose is to lift him up.
Yeah.
Our purpose is to know that everything that we do, God is there watching us.
Yes.
And the thing about it is, we have two things we have to do. We have to remain faithful.
Yes.
And we have to fight unbelief. Because unbelief will get us to a place where we'll stray away from the vine.
Yes.
We'll stray away from the root. And we'll be over there messing with a cactus stood over here with the truth.
Yes.
The true vine.
Yes.
So we have to understand it, and then we have to understand that God has a place for you in his kingdom. There is no one that God doesn't have a place for. There is no one that he's not utilizing in his kingdom. If you feel like you're not being utilized, you feel like you're not connected to the I am, it's time to take your relationship to the next level. We often talk in our naturals like we need to move from this point to the next level in our relationships. Well, I'm saying here, move to the next level in the I am. Move to the next level in the true vine.
Yes.
Move to the next level.
Yes.
And allow God to bless you.
Yes.
And understand that you can't abide in the I am. You can't abide in God without first saying, you know what? I have sinned and I'm in need of the root. I'm in need of a savior. I'm in need of a Messiah. I'm in need of one who has come and saved me, and that's Jesus.
Yeah.
So I'm here to say, and in conclusion, I thank God today that I'm connected to the vine. I thank God today that I'm connected to the I am. I thank God today that in all that I think about, all that I do, all my idiosyncrasies, my failures even, I know that he still has providence in my life.
Yes.
He has providence in the world. Nothing happens without him knowing. So we don't need to get caught up in all the things that are going on in the world. Yes, we are part of the world, but we're sojourners.
Yes.
We're temporarily here. Because the Bible tells us, you know, that one time, at some point, we're going to be absent from this body.
Yes.
And we're going to be present with the Lord.
Yes.
And you know what? I look forward to that day. I'm not rushing it. But I'm looking forward to the day when I can hear him say, well done,
yes,
thy good and faithful servant. You may enter into the joy of the Lord. So I implore you and I encourage you today, stay connected. If you're not connected, get connected there's benefits in being connected to the I Am.
Yes.
God bless you. Amen.
Yes, amen, amen, and amen.
Amen. We just thank God for a word today. We want to remind the saints of God from Sanctuary Baptist Church that we still have an opportunity and we still have an avenue to where we can be a blessing to the church through our giving. Amen. If you go to the page, Sanctuary Baptist, you can give. Also, you can contact one of the officers of the church if you have any difficulty with that. Also, on Tuesday evenings at 7 o'clock, yours truly is hosting a Bible study, amen, with the Sanctuary Oracles of God. We invite you to come and take part. It is an interactive Bible study. It's one where we can have biblical arguments, make sure that we end up on the same page. It's a place to where we can all come and dine and feast on the Word of God. So we ask you, if you haven't, or if you're on Facebook, go ahead and hit the like button for Sanctuary Baptist Fellowship Church. Amen. We ask you to keep Pastor Lester, Sister Joyce Lester, and the Lester family in prayer. We ask that you would keep myself, Pastor Samuel Gale, and all the ministers that are of the church in prayer. Keep your sisters and brothers in prayer, and pray for your family. That if they're not connected to the vine, connected to the I Am, that they would be connected to the I Am. So therefore, we have our giving, we have our communication, and we have our connection with our family. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
God bless.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I am going to return it off now. Yeah, you can do that. Hallelujah. Salvation and glory.